I want to tell you a little bit about the school that I was working at. It was a nonprofit organization, Union Settlement. It's located in East Harlem, El Barrio. And it was an adult education program. I've been an educator for more than 25 years in the nonprofit world. And the adult education program served about 1,000 people each year,
wow.
18 and older. And it was a beautiful community, and it still is a wonderful learning program, because the students we had were representing the urban population. Most of them were people that left high school for various reasons, were trying to get their high school equivalency. We had people that were returning from prison. We had students that were immigrants that were learning English as their first language. And for me, I was very proud because our program was a place for people to reinvent themselves, see themselves in a new way. And we were doing that through education. But the technology piece then brought out even more for us to explore as a learning community. So what I called this was the impact of creating video. And it really was from an awkward project to a program mainstay. It was really starting with an idea that technology was part of our world and that we could create media. And what's very interesting, when we first found out about this grant that was available, and I brought it up to the teachers on our team, they actually laughed at me. At that time, we weren't really using video. It was the idea of the chalkboard or the whiteboard that was for learning. But it was very interesting because it was laughable. Not only to the teachers, well, how are we going to do that? We don't know how to do this. It was also a little laughable to the students because they could not imagine themselves as media makers. And I'm talking now, this must have been in 2008 when we embarked on this project. So it's a little surprising that at that time, even at that time where there was technology, still in our urban community, people did not see themselves as media makers. That what they were watching on TV was this other world where we were just supposed to watch all these images. So we applied for this. It was a community technology grant, and we were awarded $10,000 worth of equipment and free training. So, and there was training for one person, me. So it was very interesting because the other laughable part of this, where people would say, well, she's the director and a teacher, she's gonna be a producer and use cameras, that's really funny too. And so I had to just still go ahead and go do the training, and still, even though the energy at the school and even at the institution was, this probably won't even work out, and still move forward. Because I understood this, that media was very important in our lives. And I also believe in the Paulo Freire pedagogy, where people problem solve, where people learn by understanding their own reality for themselves and become empowered as a result of it. So those were the driving forces for me. So I actually went and took producer and camera training at night after work, really tired. I would come actually here to the 59th Street MNN office, and it was just incredible for me because I also discovered the creativity that I had inside. And it was really incredible when I said, oh my God, I know how to mix the music and match it with the video, and this is fun, and I can do this. I don't know if I can teach it, but I can do this. And what was interesting, you had to complete the training in order to get the equipment. So that was another sort of scary part, saying I have to successfully pass whatever exam they give me because I need to show that we can do this. Now, what's very interesting, I also remembered when we got this wonderful equipment. It was this professional camera. We got a Macintosh computer. And then we're located in El Barrio. So my next worry was, how are we going to secure this? Our other fear was, this stuff is just going to get stolen. Like, there's no way we're going to have all this great tech equipment here in a little rundown office at a nonprofit, and it's not going to disappear. Well, I can tell you that we secured it. And we bought a cabinet with a lock, and it was our, like, in one office in a corner, and that was the workstation. And if it took as much space as this thing here, that's about what it was. But I'd like to say, and I share this because if you're thinking of using media with the people you work with or the community you're in, please know you can start with a little cabinet an awful, almost be in this laughable situation where it's not credible at all.
Did we put the cabinet together? We had to construct it, right?
Yeah, the cabinet had to be constructed. Yes, yes, exactly. So what was really interesting as we started using the technology with our students, first of all, at that time, our first topic was actually the history of East Harlem and gentrification. And at that time, gentrification was really starting to take over our communities. And it was, many of my students either lived in the old tenement buildings or in the housing projects. And so we were just watching these buildings being built around us, and we knew they weren't for us. So it served as this great conversation of, let's talk about this, let's interview people, let's capture this story. Now, what was very interesting as we started filming first, I call it like breaking the ice, breaking the glass of media. First of all, the students were, when we went out the first time to film, it was as if we were like in this matrix, like, what are we doing? And it was very interesting because it was that awkward step of first interviewing someone from our community, sort of being reporters in our space, and people being curious about us walking around with cameras. And it was so incredible because once we started, it was like this great energy. And we really found that our people in our community were really ready to tell us stuff. And they were telling it to us in English and Spanish and answering really private topics like, how do you feel about gentrification? How is this affecting you? And it was incredible to have that conversation in the streets while we were filming. It was just something really powerful for our feeling of almost like breaking away some of the feeling of oppression and of the feeling of there's a takeover and we can't do anything about it. Was that we can talk about it and we can film it. Another thing that was a breakthrough for my community is seeing our faces on camera. And it was really interesting for me because this was something I didn't even realize for myself. How awkward we all felt when we started looking at our recordings, like, wow, I really look like that? Well, that doesn't look like the people I usually see. Is it okay to like it? I don't like the way I look. It makes me feel funny. And that was another breakthrough moment of us even talking about that, that we are so used to seeing images that do not look like us, that we're even feeling this feeling of ineptitude when we're staring at ourselves. And how wonderful it became when people were okay with seeing themselves and hearing their voices on camera. So the first video we completed was about the gentrification of East Harlem. And what was really interesting, we did that video before anyone started making videos about that. And it was just really powerful. And this first video, what was interesting, was long hours of editing, which I was only doing by myself at the beginning, and a handful of students who were like into this, and two teachers that said, okay, we'll sort of test this out with you. So this journey of us really learning and learning about ourselves and our community, to me, was just incredible. And making a final product, for me, was like, this is like the cherry on top. But the journey getting there, that's where the essence is. And you know, it hurts my heart to think that MNN or the people who are in charge actually think that there wasn't something really taking place. That a lot of things happened with a $10,000 grant that maybe they'll never understand. So, and I want to tell you too, our first presentation was on a dilapidated TV. We found the biggest TV we could find. It was on a cart, the way they cart it into classrooms. And that's what we used to show our first film to the community. And so from the beginning till about these 5 years later, because it was turned into a five-year program. And what happened, it evolved in a way that we were able to get funding from city and state agencies because we could show that there was a curriculum that people could learn science, they could learn history, they could learn sociology by using technology. And so I was actually able to get funding from the Department of Youth and Community Development. I got funding from the city council. Obama came into office that year, and I remember we got an ARA grant and it allowed us to use technology. So it was very interesting, because once we had a product that we could show and had sort of the steps of how we took the students, then we were able to get funding for it. And I want to share that because it's something that as educators you might want to think about, that you can add that technology piece, and that it just becomes very powerful in applying for funding. The other part of being on public access was now that we were being seen on TV. And it was really interesting when students were now reporting to me, oh, I saw you on television, or we saw our film. Or even strangers would stop by and say, oh, you were the lady on TV talking about domestic violence. How cool is that? And that was another breakthrough as well, when people are seeing their own people from their community on television. And I think that's an aspect when we're talking about what should stay and what needs to change. There still needs to be a presence of real people on a television screen. And I think that's so important to all our communities. So the evolution of the project went from this very, we're gonna do this, haha, it's funny, to becoming actually a really important part of the curriculum and of the program at Union Settlement. And I would like to say that I know in my heart that this experience has changed hundreds of students that came through our program. And many of those students now are in college or finished college, got their high school equivalencies, are working. And so this media project was really, really just important in as far as people having this experience in media, but also learning about themselves. So I really encourage people, if you have this idea, and even if you don't know about media or cameras yourself, to please really consider that, about the power of creating media with the people that are part of your life or your learning circle, that there is so much magic there that goes beyond just the creation of the story, but it's about you discovering yourself within your community.
Wow.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Wow.